court than any one man. You can run him down by height and weight. No one has been as much for wrestling as Ric Flair. To see his end in Richmond, Virginia, like that, with his head being shaved, his family being held against their will, forced to watch it. Disgraceful.
Now, what's going through the mind of Kevin Nash? Does he know his nephew Hunter is not any longer in the company of Scott Steiner's Hoochies? He has to face Bill Goldberg under very emotional circumstances. What could Kevin Nash possibly be thinking, Tony?
Well, then what are the filthy animals doing out there?
Well, they're coming out with a show of unified support for the hired gun of the New Blood. In the swinging back and forth of the balance of power, I think you can safely say now, with Flair's career over, with Goldberg, the hired gun of Russo and Bischoff, the balance of power is firmly in the court of the New Blood. But a good question brought up by Mark Madden. What is going through the mind of Kevin Nash? He has waited over 2 hours, almost 2 hours, in a squad car.
Very clamped up.
For this matchup, very calmly. He doesn't even have his wrestling attire on. He has jeans on, and he's taking the fight to Goldberg, and the two most dominating figures in all of sports entertainment are slugging it out here in our feature battle on Monday Night Raw.
At Starrcade 98, Kevin Nash and Scott Hall in a taser gun ended the undefeated streak and the World Heavyweight Championship reign of Bill Goldberg. Somewhere in the back of Goldberg's mind, he wants revenge for that one again.
Bigfoot Goldberg goes down. And Goldberg quickly goes on the outside and looks, smiles, and grins and sneers at Kevin Nash.
Kevin Nash put him right down with that big boot. Guys, you can't pick a winner here. This is like the U.S. versus Russia in the 60s. The whole place could blow up by the time Goldberg versus Nash is over tonight.
Goldberg, thug life, smiling. He took the boot to the face from the seven-footer, stood up, and is getting right back into the ring.
Ducks low and all, knocks the face of Kevin Nash right off. And I just wonder somehow, somewhere, exactly what they said to Goldberg to make him turn this way. What motivation do they use for Goldberg? What buttons did Bischoff and Russo push to make Goldberg to turn him into this type of man?
Did you see Nash go down?
Yes.
As a result of Goldberg's kick? Right after Goldberg went down, as the result of Nash's boot? Nobody can destroy these guys but each other.
But Kevin Nash is still in the game. That standing sidekick, the one that put Bret the Hitman Hart on the shelf, and he's still there. But Kevin Nash is still fighting the fight against Goldberg, now just throttling the seven-footer in the corner.
How do you prepare being cooped up in the back of a squad car? Then you walk out, and you know that your young nephew is gone, missing, and you've got to feel in the clutches, maybe in the New Blood, and you're faking the hired gun, the man impervious to injury and pain in Goldberg. How do you do it? How do you do it? This is usually when they chant Goldberg's name, but it's a whole different chant right now. Goldberg stepping around, looking around, and Nash has to pull himself up by bootstraps. Goldberg, that sign says it all.
If Nash can't stop Goldberg, then who the hell is going to?
Kevin Nash may be the last great hope to put a stop to the run of Thug Life Goldberg. Putting the boots to Kevin Nash. How many times have you seen Kevin Nash in this predicament? Never.
You have to admit, there's something magnificent about Goldberg. He's unleashed. He's running wild. Ooh, now he had a face full of turnbuckle.
And let's not forget that also that Kevin Nash has many more years in the ring experience on him. The New Blood. It's the filthy animals coming out. And Kevin Nash takes them off. And Goldberg's got a tear. Goldberg's got a tear. Nash goes down.
Kevin Nash was making the comeback, and Goldberg walked him with that steel chair. Look at Goldberg. The intensity on his face, absorbing the accolades of the New Blood.
I will never understand in my entire lifetime what just happened right there. The man who's the monster, Goldberg, does he need physically the filthy animals? The answer, no. Does he need a steel chair against a Kevin Nash or anybody? The answer is no. But now he takes the glove off.
Oh! Those hands are legal.
Wait a minute. It's young Hunter. It's the 8-year-old nephew of Kevin Nash, who now has come up on the steps, who is screaming out to his uncle.
Hunter watching from the ring.
What? Hunter, do not get in the ring. What is Russo doing back here? What? What low light? He's got Hunter.
Oh, look at that. He's forcing Hunter.
He's making Hunter watch. He's holding on to Hunter. He's making him watch, and he's laughing. It's Goldberg.
Kevin Nash can even see his nephew, Kevin Nash. Oh, here comes Big Papa Pump.
The crowd and the young man.
Scott Steiner clearing house with a new blood.
He's seen enough. Yeah. Here comes, yeah, he's knocking out policemen. He's hit policemen. They're going to throw him. They're going to throw him in jail the rest of his life.
Oh, they're beating him. They're beating him. They're beating him. Papa Pump and Billy Clubs with nightsticks. They are just beating him like a criminal.
There is no stopping Russo in the new blood. There is no stopping Goldberg.
That's what happens when you hit a cop. Scott Steiner knew the risk after he's been down that road before. He's being hauled off to the Hooskow. Meanwhile, Goldberg still unloading.
A cheap shot from the cat. How cheap, how low can you get? We have seen a new all-time low on Monday Nitro, which has been on the air since Labor Day of 95. We have never seen the low.
And there's Hunter. Hunter's in the ring.
In the ring.
Get out of there. For Pete's sake, Hunter. Billy wouldn't go after the kid, would he?
Oh, God, I hope not.
Pay him enough, he'll do anything.
And Russo dancing, hugging Goldberg. It's a new low.